Let us discuss about the bound charges on a dielectric surface and electric field. Say there's a dielectric slab given to us and we apply an external electric field E onto this dielectric slab. In the previous section, we have studied that due to application of this electric field, all dipoles will get aligned in the direction of electric field due to the couple exerted onto these dipole by the electric field. And we can see on the surface, left surface, there are some negative charges induced due to the alignment of dipoles, of which the surface density we can write as minus sigma I. And on the right side, some positive charges are induced due to the alignment of dipole, which is plus sigma I. These charges which are induced on the surface due to the alignment of dipole are called bound charges on the dielectric surface. Now, due to these negative charges, some electric lines of the electric field will terminate onto this and remaining will as it is pass on because this is not a metal, so all electric lines can never directly terminate on the surface. If it would have been a metal, all electric lines will terminate, or we can say charges are induced till the overall flux will terminate on the surface and inside electric field becomes zero. In this situation, we can see the external electric field is E, and due to these induced charges, an opposite electric field EP is developed, which is called polarizing electric field in opposite direction, due to which the flux density within the dielectric slab decreases. So here we can say that the electric field inside dielectric, this can be written as E inside is equals to E minus EP, about which we know it can be written as E by epsilon r. We have discussed in the previous section, if epsilon r is the relative permittivity of the dielectric medium, which is deciding the amount of electric lines which are permitted into the dielectric medium, remaining are terminated on the bound charges on the surface. Now, in this situation, we can see if external electric field is E, internal is EP. EP is obviously due to these bound charges. The magnitude of this EP we can write as sigma I by epsilon naught if these surfaces are considered to be large compared to the thickness and the uniformity of electric field is considered onto it. Then, on placing the value of sigma I over here, you can see we are getting the magnitude of EP is equals to E multiplied by 1 minus 1 by epsilon r. On substituting the value of EP over here, we can see the density of induced charges on the surface of dielectric slab. We can see this equals to epsilon naught E 1 minus 1 by epsilon r. This is quite a useful relation you should keep in mind. This is the surface density of bound charges induced on dielectric surface. Based on this, many different kind of situation we'll see later. But this is quite an important section you should always keep in mind. Here you can also see one thing which is useful, that outside the dielectric slab, the density of electric lines will remain same, these are not affected. Whereas inside the dielectric slab, the density of line is reduced. Outside, everywhere it will remain same, as no effect will be there due to bound charges on the surrounding medium.